me, Roy, Ronnie, and Duncan walked across the street. Stevie was talking to these boys, and Roy asked one of the boys for a cigarette, reached over and grabbed, got him out of his pocket, and took a cigarette out. And the guys, one of the kids had a gun. He stepped around the back of all of me, Roy, and Ronnie, and pointed the gun at us, told us to leave, or he's going to shoot us. And we all thought it was a blank gun, so we started at him to take the gun away from him. Then he fired a shot in the ground, and I said, blank guns don't scare me. And then he fired a shot at me, and that time Roy ran out and get the gun away, and the kid shot him.
Well, it's just horrible. I mean, I feel real bad because I keep seeing the look on his face when he rolled over. Because I was on top of the boy when he rolled over, and I heard him scream, and it's just terrible. I mean, I don't know, it really makes me feel bad, because I really can't believe it happened, you know, because Roy is such a nice guy.
This afternoon, I talked to Mr. Jack Harrington, the Assistant Federal Administrator for Renewal Assistance, concerning the Fort Worth Neighborhood Improvement Program, and specifically, the case of Mrs. A.D. Carrizales. Harrington firmly defended the total program and pointed out the alternative to that, which was accomplished in her case, that according to the housing code, Mrs. Carrizales could have been evicted. But Mr. Harrington assured us that because of the question raised by Channel 8's inquiry, an investigation into alleged irregularities would be made.
Well, actually, it started because of some overloaded jobs. In fact, we've got some 40 to 50, or in excess of 50, overloaded jobs presently. Now, the company has added work to these jobs. The people are unable to perform them in a fair day's work. Now, our contract calls for a fair day's work for a fair day's pay. And if these people perform these jobs, then they would have to be working in excess of normal. And then on top of this, in order to try to coerce the people into performing these operations, management has been giving disciplinary layoffs up to as much as 30 days off. And we think that this is unreasonable, something that, as far as the local union is concerned, that we cannot live with.
I think yesterday the board muffed its opportunity to make a conscientious effort to clean its house. I think it should have had Mr. Stevenson and other top officials, salaried officials, testify. I was disappointed they didn't subpoena him. I found out after I talked to you yesterday in the Attorney General's office that some question whether they have enforcement powers of subpoena.
We feel that this undertaking is an overall plan complex, and that therefore the building work and the site work are one and the same undertaking, that the plans and specifications, although the phases of the work may be undertaken at different times, that they will coordinate and dovetail to such an extent that the project is cohesive, it is integral, similar, and related, and therefore it is building work.